Hello, family and friends. I am Sally Garrison Fields. For those who are not familiar with me, I am the daughter of the late Walter B. and Helen Garrison, and a granddaughter of Lorenzo and Alice Garrison. As one of our host Garrison committee members for 2020, we were prepared for our annual family reunion, but circumstances beyond our control caused us to come to you through modern technology, thanks to Curtis Davis, Keith Wiggins, and Ms. Mona Simmons. Our Aunt Kitty said it best. Look at it this way. We have had 61 glorious years of family reunions. So I say, how many families can say that? All we have to do is to remember and understand that God has this virus under His control. All we have to do is trust and believe that He will see us through. This would have been our banquet time. So, in lieu of showing up in person, a video has been prepared to bless our hearts and souls. So sit back, relax, enjoy, and reminisce of past times. Please don't forget to hug yourself until our next family reunion.
My name is Navier Davis. I am the son of Sandro Davis and a grandson of Stephen Navarro Davis and Sandra Davis. I've been coming to the family reunion for a long time, since I was little, and I like coming. I always have fun, and I think it's important. I get to learn about my family heritage and those that came before me. I get to connect with my family. I get to see people that's the same age as me, and we always have fun when we see each other. I get to create memories, and hopefully, as we get older, my generation, we keep the tradition going, because I like going every year, and I wish we could have gone this year.
Yeah, you want to say something to Jess and Mama? Okay. You tell her whatever you want to say. Now you can tell him thank you, Mama. You tell Jesse what you want to tell him, because we're going to send him with his tape. What you want to tell Jesse? Tell Jesse what you want to tell him.
Tell him we had a nice time. I'm sorry.
Tell him miss it. Daddy, you want to say something to Jesse?
We know God's children, and we know that He loves us one and all. We all don't see just alike, but we all understand it all. By and by, when the morning comes, when all God's children be gathering her. How'd you tell the story? How you overcome?
Which one?
But when we get there, I know you love God heavy. And look who they could all the way beat me. At the real book judge. Sit down.
Y'all want some corn on the cob?
No.
No. Well, yeah, this
shot. Y'all want some corn? You want some corn?
Shut the harvest over. Say, Lord, you don't sit down. Ha ha. Look, I hear him out with this.
All right.
I say hey to Mary and Charles.
Go tell Mama to say that.
Mama, you talk to Mary and Charles. Hey, Mary and Charles.
Say
hello. Good.
Hi, Mary and Charles. And Jesse.
Hey, yeah.
We're sorry we couldn't come, but we had a nice time.
Tell Jean you heard she was almost here too.
And away, Jean, look at tell the
Jean. Tell Jean too. Okay, talk to him.
Jesse, you just led all of my children. Baby boy.
You're talking now.
Hey, one way you know to see the
other.
Jesse
was his best child.
What did he say? What?
Did he say Jesse was his best child?
No, he didn't.
Uh-oh, Jesse, we were just getting ready to get you. We thought he said you were his best child.
Get your chair and pull up that Bible. Get your chair.
No, I'm looking. Hello, one thing follows me. I played music. Bass in the choir. A deacon.
Do they stand back?
You changed it with God. You don't hear me. You don't see me no more. You tell the last word I said. God loves all of it's true. And the love is one by one.
Hello, Garrison
President. And where we all get to heaven.
Man, how you doing? Dude, who is this?
Thank you, Jesus.
I know you both can't get your voice.
But the minute you had it
right. Yeah, Miss Anna Ray, but I told you I knew that voice, but couldn't say it. How you doing? We missed you.
Take me, friend. White and right colored. Enemies, too.
Oh, yes, ma'am. So she's here. She's here. Yes. Come on.
So, enemies.
Okay, hold on a minute. Excuse me.
Don't hear me, no, boo. Come on.
This ain't right here. Hi, girl. How come you didn't
I feel good.
Huh? Thank you. Thank you, dear. Come on in.
I know, you know.
Did you eat it? Could you eat it?
My heart.
It was nice.
No medicine.
Well, I'm glad it was.
Okay. And look at this one out here.
See you again.
See you again.
But that's what I say. Jesse, we had been missed you, child. We enjoyed it, though. We had a nice time, dear. I just wish you could have been there.
And you know what? After you, I told him you wasn't coming home, he cried just like a little baby.
For about an hour.
He cried for about an hour. He really did.
Who was it?
Why? Yeah, because I heard him. I said, God knows I can't go down there tonight. You got to start crying in the day.
I'm my strength. Strength like no other. Strength like no other. Reaches to me. Yes. You are my strength. Strength like no other.
Prophesy, declare it.
Strength like no other.
Let me hear you declare it.
Strength like no other.
Now say it reaches.
Reaches.
Let's declare it one more time. You are my strength. Come on.
You are my strength.
Yes, you are.
Strength like no other. Like no other.
And it reaches to me. Come on, say in the fullness of your grace. Come on, church.
In the fullness of your grace.
In the power of your name.
In the power of your name.
Let me testify.
You lift me up.
Yes. Hallelujah. One more time, in the fullness of your grace.
In the fullness of
your grace, it's amazing.
In the power of
your name, it's Jesus.
You lift me up.
Yeah, you do, Lord.
You lift me up.
Everybody say, you are my strength. Sing it without the music this time. Come on, church.
I would like to introduce yourself and present to others.
I can count on
Uncle you. Jesse Garrison. Let's give him a hand.
First Garrison family reunion, and we owe all the praise and honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Thank you all for coming here to help us participate. At this time, we're going to have our opening selection led by none other than Reverend Bobby Dotton. We are one in the family, one in the Lord.
May we all stand, please. For those of you that may not know what the song says, we're one in the family. Think about it now. We're one in the family, one in the Lord. We're bound by His Spirit, the Lord's Spirit, and washed in His blood, the blood of Jesus. And together there is nothing that we cannot overcome. Y'all come say that little line. And together?
Together.
Okay, one more time. And together?
And together.
For the Holy Ghost this time. And together?
And together.
There is nothing.
There is nothing.
That we cannot overcome.
That we cannot overcome.
Why? Because we're one in the family.
We're one in the family.
And we're one in the Lord.
And we're one in the Lord.
Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. Come on, put your hands together. Amen.
Thank you.
we're one in the family. We're one in the Lord. Bound by His Spirit. Bound by His Spirit. Washed in His blood.
Because tomorrow is not promised. So what better day than today to love one another? Again, on behalf of the Garrison Family Planning Committee, welcome, welcome, welcome.
At this time, we're going to have the Old Testament by Ms. Philomena Vaughn, followed by the New Testament by Tia and Josh Meyer. Mind. That way you want to move, keep time moving, okay?
I'll be reading Isaiah 40, 40th chapter, and the 8th to the 31st verse. The grass withered, the flowers fade, but the word of our God shall stand forever. O Zion, thou bringest good tidings, get thee up into the high mountains of Jerusalem, thou bringest good tidings, lift up thy voice with strength, lift it up, be not afraid. Say unto the cities of Judah, behold your God. Behold the Lord, God will come with strong hands, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him. He shall feed his flock like a shepherd. He shall gather the lambs with his arms, and carry them in his bosom, and shall gently lead those that are with young. Who had measured the waters with the hollow of his hands, and meted out heaven with a span, and comprehended the dust of the earth in a measure, and weighed the mountains in scales, and the hills in a balance? Who had directed the Spirit of the Lord, or being his counselor, had taught him? With whom took he counsel, and who instructed him, and taught him in the path of his judgment, and taught him knowledge, and shewed to him the way of understanding? Behold, the nations are as a drop of a bucket, and are counted as the small dust of the balance. Behold, he taketh up the isles as a very little thing. And Lebanon is not sufficient to burn, nor the beast thereof sufficient for a burnt offering. All nations before him are as nothing, and they are counted to him less than nothing and vanity. To whom then will you liken God? Or what likeness will you compare unto him? The workman melted a gravel image, and the goldsmith spreaded it, covered it with gold, and cast silver chains. He that is so improvised that he had ability choseth a tree that will not rot. He seeketh unto him a cunning workman to prepare a graven image that shall not be moved. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Had it not been told you from the beginning? Had you not understand from the foundation of the earth? It is he that sitteth upon the circle of the earth, and the inhabitants therefore are grasshoppers that stretched out the heavens as a curtain, and spreadeth them out as a tent to dwell in. That bringeth the prince to nothing. He maketh the judge of the earth as vanity. Yea, they shall not be planted. Yea, they shall not be sown. Yea, their stock shall not take root in the earth. And he shall also blow upon them, and they shall wither. And the whirlwind shall take them away as stubble. To whom then will you liken me? Or shall I be equal? Said the Holy One. Lift up your eyes unto the hills, and behold who hath created these things, that bringeth out their hosts by number. He called them all by names, by the greatness of his might, for that he is strong in power, not one failing. Why sayest thou, O Jacob, and speakest, O Israel, my name is hid from the Lord, and my judgment is passed over from my God? Hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary? There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increased strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word.
Amen.
workshop here. I'm a teenager, and I open with, "What's up, y'all?" I'm 30-something, so I'm just saying, "Good afternoon." We're going to be reading the book of Matthew, chapter 24, verses 3 to 14. Later, Jesus sat on the Mount of Olives. His disciples came to him privately and said, "Tell us, when will all this happen? What sign will signal your return and the end of the world?" Jesus told them, "Don't let anyone mislead you, for many will come in my name claiming I am the Messiah. They will deceive many, and you will hear of wars and threats of wars, but don't panic. Yes, these things must take place, but the end won't follow immediately. Nation will go to war against nations and kingdom against kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes in many parts of the world, but all this is only the first of the birth pains with more to come.
Then you will be arrested, persecuted, and killed. You will be hated all over the world because you are my followers. And many will turn away from me and betray and hate each other. And many false prophets will appear and will deceive many people. Sin will be rampant everywhere, and the love of many will grow cold. But the one who endures to the end will be saved. And the good news about the kingdom will be preached throughout the whole world so that all nations will hear it, and then the end will come."
Thank you, Brother Wayne O'Brien. And thank you, T and Josh. Now we introduce it to you for prayer, Otis and Ruth Squires. Nothing works well without prayer, and prayer changes things. I just want to let you know. Just listen.
Take care of your parents.
telling you today, oh God, oh I know he's resting, but it still hurts me to know that I'm not going to see him anymore. It hurts me, but I know God don't make no mistakes. He doesn't make any mistakes, and everything today is going to change. And Lord, Father God, just help me and help the family. And I know a lot of the children, Father God. Because we used to be together all the time. And I know a lot of them today sad. But he's in heaven. I believe granddad is in heaven with Jesus. And you don't have to worry about him anymore. And Lord Jesus, I pray, Father God, that you would give me. Give me, Lord, what I need you to do. To get thinking about my grandkids. Lord, bless the Garrison. He was a good man. He was a good man. Lord, if we needed anything, he would be right there. Children, do you have anything? Do you have anything? Do you need anything? He took care of my mother the same. He always was glad to be there. Just come right down to it. It was like a little road. And he would come right down here every day to see what we need. And Lord, I thank you. Lord, I love you. I wish we could get him back, but I know he's gone to be with the Father. And right now, Lord, I give my prayer. I give it to you, Jesus. But you know what we need. You know what he needed. And you took care of him. And you took care of the family. And Lord, right now, I just wish I could see my grandchildren. And maybe one day, I believe I will meet him again in that beautiful city. Lord, thank you. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Lord.
From God, he has for us. It's a matter of us reaching
for what God has for us. Or he asked me, because I had made a phone call to Sister Cora and Bonnie about 2 weeks ago, maybe 3 weeks ago, and my money was a little short, and I was trying to go ahead and get my money in for the reunion. And so I asked her, I said, can you give me to next week or pages? She said, yeah, that's fine. And then, I guess it was about maybe a few hours later, or maybe the next day, I'm not totally sure. And then she said, can you speak to the family? And I said, I'm thinking to myself, well, what in the world the family want to hear from me about? You know what I mean? But I thank God still, you know, for opportunity, because I want to say to you that I love you, all of you. I love you, family and friends, and those that are friends, we call you family. Amen. Amen. Extension is everything. Intention is something, but extension is everything. And whether the extension is, the intention's got to be right. Is that right? Amen. All right. So we're gonna try and just speak to you for a moment. Amen. I know that the theme, they talked about strength and endurance. Man, and I began to think about, man, what in the world can we speak about strength? Because there are so many dynamics to strength. And because of that fact, we have to understand that God has placed strength as a word to be used in various ways. The strength that you have in an area may not be the strength that I have in an area. But yet the strength that you have in the area can help me in the area that I don't have strength. We're not going to try to rush and push too fast. We're going to get out of your way, but we're not going to try to rush and push too fast. I want to read a scripture coming from Matthew, coming from Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 12. Amen. Verse number 1. Therefore we are also surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses. Amen. Let us lay aside every weight and every sin which so easily ensnares or besets us, and let us run with patience. Let us run with patience. Man, this says let us run with endurance. Amen. The race that is set before us. I'm going to ask you to bow your heads real quickly. God, we bless you now, and we thank you for this time. We thank you for this opportunity, Lord, and we know that without you, we can do nothing. God, but we look for you right now, the author and the finisher of our faith. God, to hide us, oh God, that you, oh God, will reveal yourself, that you would anoint us, oh God, for a purpose, Lord, that is greater than ourselves, that everything that's said is said for your glory. That everything that's done is done for your honor. We thank you for it right now in the matchless name of Jesus Christ. Let everybody say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Amen. 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 The scripture says here that there is therefore, we're surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses. Amen. And it tells us to lay aside every weight and every sin that so easily besets us. But then it says, let us run the race with endurance. And that's the area right now that we're talking about. It's the enduring part. I was thinking about Granddaddy and Mama Allison. I was thinking how they had some vision for what family should be. I was reading the bio and I was noticing that, you know, it's been 102 years ago that they married. It said 1917. Is that right? Is that right, Uncle Jesse? It said 1917. So here we are now, fast forward 102 years later. Amen. That's what I said, wow. I said, when you look around, you really don't understand how endurance becomes something that is so vital. There are so many families that I know, I talk to them, and they have not even come close to getting 61 years. Folks don't even get 6 years because they don't even try to come together. But here we are now in our 61st, which they were married 102 years ago. Praise the name of the Lord. So we now have an obligation. I wanted to use the word also a commission. Because they challenged us that you got to keep it going. Somebody said, the scripture said, add thou to it. Amen. And as we look around, we're talking about family, and then we're talking about extension of family. So it's being added to. But now, can those things that are being added to, can they endure the test of time? Thank you, Jesus. How many of you here in the last 6 years have suffered either a loss of a loved one right in your immediate family, or a major sickness in your body?
Yes, sir.
What I need you to do right now is I need you to stand on your feet. But you have had had a suffering of a loss of a family, and I'm talking immediate family, your mother, your father, your brother, or you had a major physical injury, ailment, something that you know that the Lord, and that the Lord alone. Amen. 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 Now, the reason why I have you standing, and the reason why we say six is because God had let me know that His grace comes through the number six. Praise the name of the Lord. Because His grace comes through the number six. Amen. His grace is being multiplied upon you right now. Hallelujah. Now, I ask you one question. If you come here for nothing else, those of you that are standing right now, you got a praise and a worship for what God has done for you that can't nobody take from you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We come here to endure some things. You can be seated, thank you. We come here to endure some things. Amen. We come here to endure some things. But those things that we come to endure, we then are able to overcome those things by what? The blood of the Lamb. Thank you, Jesus. He was telling us that we have so great a cloud of witnesses. But then it tells us to run a particular race with patience. But I understand one other thing. Is that without the joy of the Lord,
all right.
That first word that says endurance, that second word says strength. So now, if without the joy of the Lord, how can we have any strength? How? If we have no joy of the Lord, isn't it woe is me? How am I going to make it? But my. When I'm down, I can get on my knees. Somebody reminded me just last night, I remember when you say lay prostrate on the ground. Hallelujah. Stuff that they don't even try and teach today. How to humble yourself before God. That you can lay prostrate before the Lord. And you can cry out unto the Lord. And when you cry out to Him, the Bible says that the joy of the Lord would be your strength. Oh, praise this wonderful name. See, I'm looking around and I'm wondering how in the world can we continue to live in such a place that we don't have joy. Hallelujah. That we don't have endurance. Thank you, Jesus. I know some of us and many of us have gone through things. And I don't mean just on a physical nature. But there are a lot of us that have gone through a mental strain. Praise the name of our God. And when the mental strain comes, isn't it sometimes worse than you having a broken arm or broken leg? The mental thing, you can't see it. But my God, you can feel it. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And I believe God that He shall do just what He said. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And because of that reasoning, I'm here to say and encourage you again. Don't quit too soon. Don't quit too soon. Hallelujah. Because see, if you quit too soon, you're not going to understand why the Lord came and brought Mama Allison, Granddaddy, to this life. That we as an offspring of those would be able to then share in the goodness of the Lord. If you quit too
too soon, you can't get the deliverance in your physical body that you would need. If you quit too soon, you won't get the nurturing of your mind that you would need. If you quit too soon, you can't get that uplifting in your finances that you can receive. If you quit too soon, you can't get the home that God wants to bless you in. If you quit too soon, you can't see what God is going to do in your tomorrow. If you quit too soon, you'll never be able to know that God is a healer. If you quit too soon, you won't know that God will bring us from death to glory. If you quit too soon. Hallelujah. But I've come here not to quit too soon, but I've come to endure hardship as a good soldier. Any of you that have been in the military, any of you that's been in any kind of academies, you understand about a good soldier. Hallelujah. A soldier sometimes may not always agree because they don't understand. But nonetheless, soldier's still marching. Sometimes they say, "Mark time, march." You, where you going? I don't know, but we're going to keep on enduring. We're going to keep on enduring. That's how the Lord is saying. We got to continue to endure. Endure, endure, endure. Because as we endure, we're teaching one another. But then those of us that have children, bless God, I got my daughter here for the, I'm going to say for the first time that I can even remember. Yeah. I'm not positive, but I'm almost positive that my daughter Danielle, she come down the road with me. Amen. And she was so excited. And she got me all excited because I just, sometimes you don't really understand like how much you can appreciate and love your children until all of a sudden one day they grow up and become an adult. Right, now sure, you nurture them when they're young. But my God, the things that you endured during that time when they was young, and now to watch them grow and have their own. And now teaching and raising them, and I'm just blessed, and I know plenty of you here right now are in the same realm. That you have raised up children, and everybody ain't going to be and do what you want. But the love that you have for them, it has to endure the test of time. It has to endure the test of time. When that love can endure the test of time, now you know that child will be strengthened. Why? Because they'll be able to come to mama. They can come to daddy, and they can talk to them, and they'll let them know that, listen, dad, I'm so glad, hey, mom, I'm so blessed that you were right there with me during the hard times, during the rough times, during the unforgettable times. I'm so glad, daddy, and I thank you. Hallelujah. But we're here right now. We're here right now for a purpose. We're here right now for a reason. And I don't know about anyone else, but my worship and my praise, I will continue to endure what God has placed in my life, because the Bible declares that, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. Anybody flash their eyes real fast, blink your eyes? That's how quick you're going to be changed one day. Those of us that are waiting, anticipating that word, anticipating when the dead in Christ shall rise. Wow, the dead in Christ shall rise? What was the operative word? The dead in Christ. Well, what did grandma and granddad teach? Huh? I once was young, and now I'm old. Mm-hmm. But I've never seen the righteous forsaken. Lord, you see, baby, break. Mm-hmm. And I'm so glad that they said it to us. I heard them say it myself. I was a young man, but I remember when granddad used to stand up and shake his head. Praise the name of our God. And he said, I once was young, but now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken. No, you see, everywhere we're gonna get old. As I walk around every year, I can see grave coming more and more. But I heard the word say, don't be waiting for the gray hair. for it's a sign of wisdom. So those of you that got a little grade, don't worry about the grade that you got. Think about the wisdom that you got from the grade that you're receiving. So don't wait on people to worship and praise God for you. You endure hardship as a good soldier, and let the Lord do the blessing of your life. Stand on your feet right now, and somebody in here got to worship and praise for the Lord, because when the praises go up, oh, praise the name of Jesus, the blessing comes down. And I'm so glad about it. I've got a praise that's greater than me. I heard the word say, hallelujah, was the highest praise. So I'm wondering right now if anybody in here got a hallelujah praise. Because see, once again, God is waiting. God anticipating somebody got a praise on their lips, got a worship in their heart, got a thank you on their mind. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody got strength today. Somebody got endurance today. Because we as a family, we're one in the spirit. I heard the song say, and we're one in the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Don't quit too soon. Hallelujah. Don't quit too soon. Thank you, Jesus. But you endure what you got to endure. Amen. But then again, the word said that let the strong bear the infirmity. Anybody know what infirmity is? Praise the name of our God. Infirmity is a type of sickness. Once again, you don't have to have a physical infirmity. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Huh? You don't have to have a physical ailment that I can see. But I'm still to bear the infirmity, and you're still to bear my infirmity. Thank you, Jesus. I'm not to look at you and talk you down. I see our young people walking around here trying to figure it out. Trying to figure it out. Why? Because we have all kinds of matter of madness going on in this world. Hallelujah. Even as you look around, you can sit down. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Even as we look around, you can see all the things that's happening. You can see it. And it's mass confusion. But understand one thing. And I need you to hear me clearly. Understand one thing. That there is nothing that's going on right now that shouldn't be going on right now. Y'all hear me? There is nothing that's going on right now that should not be going on. Did not the Lord say in the last days the little many are going to wax cold? Yeah. Yeah. Amen. Did not the Lord say in the last days men are going to be lovers of themselves? Yeah. More than lovers of God? Huh? Isn't that what the word say? Yeah. I don't hear amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That means let it be so.
Yeah.
Man, this is our time right now. To prove to the world, that we are a peculiar people.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Zealous unto good works. So if somebody's talking about my family, I'm trying to tear them down, well, I might not put it up like that. Let you know straight up that you don't do that. That's my family right there. Huh? And whatever it is, I guarantee you, somebody or you got it worse. Even more. You pray for them. But we as a family, we know we have to. We must. It's commissioned for us to pray for one another.
Yes.
Strength and endurance. And as long as we continue to walk in the strength, we can endure hardship. And we can make it. We can make it. We can make it. One day we're going to take off these clothes.
Yes.
And we're going to put on a robe. Ain't that what we anticipated?
Yes.
That's what we anticipated. Ain't that right, Uncle Jesse? We anticipating that. That one day we're going to take off these clothes, we're going to put on a robe. Hallelujah. And then we can walk around the city. We can walk around the place of Jesus Christ. My God, I was trying to think sometimes, what in the world would this person look like? Praise the name of our God. But then in the long run of all things, does it really matter? Because what he's done is he's taken us and he's changed us. He's molded us and he's shaped us into being his own. Amen.
Amen.
So we continue to anticipate by having strength and endurance. I love you. I thank God for you. I thank God for the opportunity. I pray that you've been encouraged. I pray that you will encourage me. I pray that everything that you receive from this day forward is for your uplift and not for your downtrod. Amen.
Amen.
I love you. I love you. I love you.
Thank you, Minister Johnny Moore, for that overflowing message. You know it's great when you can run out of time before you run out of God's word. At this time, we're going to do this, and then we're going to have Deacon Moore to come in after to bless the food. But we want to make sure that our young people get an opportunity to bring their message and song to selections. And after that, Deacon Johnny Moore, the father of Reverend Johnny Moore, just gave you this word of wisdom, he's going to bless the food. So this time, let's turn it over to our young people, our youth choir. The Garrison Young Youth.
Thank you.
Where's Deacon Moore?
Right here.
Okay, Carlton, could you give me a deep seat? Anyway, dear God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We want to thank you for this day to happen, Father. We want to thank you for all family members that are here, Father. Thank you for the ones that wanted to be here that could not be here. We ask that you will bless them wherever they may be. Also bless us when we leave here, that your spirit will be in us. To let the world know that you live within each and every one of us. Right now, Father, we ask that you will bless this food we're about to receive. Bless the hands that prepared it. Let it be nourishment for our bodies. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Now the food is getting ready to be served. At this time, after this table over here, I don't want to just say head table because God is the head. We just happen to be the siblings and the sibling representative of the Garrison family reunion. After we get started, then everyone can fall in place. Hold on a minute. You want to use the mic, sir? You want to use the mic so they can hear?
No, he's getting ready to do the hand tables and then they'll start. The
okay.
Thank you.
this time I'd like to give a special thanks to a few people. Tracy Prado McKenzie. She made the massages for the aunts. Where's Tracy? Tracy, right? She's not here, okay. And also, we'd like to Arisha, where are you, Arisha? Can you stand, please? Arisha did the banner, the Garrison Family Reunion banner. We got a few things we're going to be going from the program, and other things we may deviate just a little bit. First of all, I'd like to ask my wonderful wife, Cassandra, and Hope to come forth and give you a little short presentation on something that took place over the past year that the family was instrumental in a mission trip. So she's going to give you a little snapshot about that. Let's say amen for her.
Last year, around this time, we were collecting money for the mission trip that my daughter and I went to on last July, and we went to the Dominican Republic. And we were able to raise money here, which funded our trip, which I just was just really so thankful for everyone who was praying for us and everyone who was able to give to the effort. We were able to go to the Dominican Republic, and we were able to minister to the families and the children in a place called Los Cocos in the Dominican. And when we were there, we were able to have vacation Bible school where we were able to teach them the Word of God. We were able to bring them food. Our church was able to send over 100 dresses for the little girls, and also they made pants for the little boys. Also, with the conditions over there, I just wanted to try to give you a snapshot of how it was. Of course, it was hot because it was in the Dominican. But just imagine yourself. You wake up in the morning, and then you step, you know, you put your feet out, and you're stepping out on the ground. That's how they were. They had been placed, these were Haitian refugees in the Dominican, and they had been placed in this area that had more like volcanic rock. So they had no floor in their home at all. Everything was just on hard rock. So when you woke up in the morning, you were automatically putting your feet on that hard dirt in the hard rock. And so the homes were just made of wood and tin. A lot of them didn't have much of a roof, so when it rained, everything was just wet. But you know, it showed us that we are really blessed here. So whenever you get out of bed or whenever you have to wash your floor or vacuum it, just be thankful you have a floor to wash, for sure. And again, thank you for your financial support. Thank you for your prayers. And then my daughter, hopes she's going to elaborate a little more.
So last year I did, that was my first mission trip ever, and I'm glad that I got to spend it with my mom because she helped me along the way along with the other group members. We were in a place called Los Cocos, and there were the Haitian refugees in the Dominican, so it's like Haiti didn't want them and the Dominican didn't want them, so we were able to go to them and show them love and God's love even better and minister to them. And what I was able to do with the donations that y'all so greatly did, I was able to teach reporters to them how to play Amazing Grace and Jesus Loves Me. And it was just amazing because there's a language barrier, but it's like God was in language and he crushed everything there and was able to allow us to pour out our love and his spirit to them. And it was just a really wonderful time.
Yeah. Let's give them another hand. For those of you who do not know, Hope is a rising, soon-to-be graduate of high school in June. I do have one announcement to make, because it does involve my family. Stephen, would you come up here, please, and introduce your guest? Charlotte, she's still in school. She graduates May 3rd, by the way, with a doctorate in physical therapy. But this is my beautiful fiance, Brianna Kanae Holmes.
Off their knees when the prayer is over.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We've been noticing quite a few of you been staying in the kneel position for the entire church service. We thought it was because the Holy Ghost was working on ya. But we found out it was your knees gave out. Hallelujah. So you know your bodies better than we do. If that's you, please remain standing doing all tomorrow. Amen? Amen. Now this next announcement is from, let's see who this one's from. Okay, this is from the video ministry. Choir members. I'm talking about y'all. I'm talking about y'all. Please help your fellow choir members stay awake on Sunday morning. Some of y'all have been caught sleeping on video and camera, okay? And a copy of this video has been sent to the Minister of Music for disciplinary action. So members, please, choir members, please help your members stay awake on Sunday, amen? Amen. Now this next one is from the Children's Church Ministry. Yes, indeed. Members, please pick your children up immediately after the morning worship service is over. Some of the children are being left a little too long in the children's church. They told me to tell you that. They told me to tell you that. But you know children are honest, and they will tell you the truth. Baby, where your mama and them? Oh no, she said she had to go to the doctor on Sunday. She went on, And sweetheart, where are your people? Oh, my mama said she had to run some errands. She had to run some errands. And Don, baby, where are your folks? My mama said she had to go pick up our Sunday's dinner from the Golden Corral. They told me to tell y'all that Children's Church is not a free babysitting service, amen? So pick those children up immediately after the morning worship service is over, okay? Okay, now this next one is from, let's see where this one is from. Let me think about this. Some of you have asked one of the requirements to be a greeter in the church. You know, you want to know, you know, people stand at the door, you know. And so there are only three requirements, but they're very important. To be a greeter or a doorkeeper or, you know, pass out the fans. One is you have to be able to smile to be a greeter. You have to, you know, you have to smile at people to be a greeter in the church. Amen? Amen. Oh, let me see some smiles in here. Oh, you could be a greeter. Oh, yes, you could be a greeter. Oh, you know you could be a greeter. Yeah. So you got to smile to be a greeter in the church. Amen?
Amen.
All right, the second requirement is you have to open your mouth and speak to people to be a greeter. You do. You really do. You can't be standing up there Sunday mornings and you just looking like this.
Amen.
No. You have to open your mouth and speak to people to be a greeter. And you got to speak to the people you like and the people you don't like. Amen?
Amen.
And we shouldn't be able to tell the difference. Amen? So come on now, people. You got to smile. And you gotta open your mouth and talk to everyone. And the last and most important requirement to be a greeter in the church, you got to get to church before church starts to be a greeter. Amen? Amen. Who is you greeting and you coming in with the folks rushing in the morning? Hey, how you doing? Hey, how you doing? Ain't you a greeting, sister? Yeah, on my way, my post. No, that is not how it works. You got to get to church before church started to be a greeter. So you got it now? You got to smile. Yes. You know your smile might be the only one they see that day. So you got to smile. You got to speak to everybody. Amen. And you got to get to church before church starts. Now, if you think that's the ministry for you, see any lady in blue today. All right? All right, now this next one is from the parking lot ministry. Lord knows, they told me to tell y'all this. Parking lot ministry, we got a lot of them in the church, brother. We got some more we're going to talk about in a minute that we had to create
because we saw it was a need. Amen. But then the parking lot minister told me to tell y'all, if you don't want to be parked on the grass, you can't come to church last. That's what they told me to tell y'all. Y'all can't get mad with mad when they tell y'all go over there and you acting like you don't know what he's saying going there. Also told me to tell y'all know your left from your right now. So start acting like you don't know what they're saying when they say go this way. They mean go this way, not that way, amen? That's what they told me to tell you. That's what. And they also told me to tell you there will be no drag racing when leaving the parking lot after the morning worship service. Amen? That's what they told me to tell you. Y'all been spinning up some wheels. Y'all been kicking some rocks and everything. Y'all got to slow it down. The speed limit for leaving the parking lot is 5 miles an hour. That's all it is, 5 miles an hour. Thanks be to God, one brother didn't get his foot rolling over last Sunday because it was a senior citizen and she was way underneath the 5 mile speed limit. I believe she was just coasting along. She was just moving so slow. So he could pull it back real quick, you understand? But the speed limit is 5 miles an hour, amen? Amen. I thought I'd tell you that one too. Hold up, I got another. This one is from, hold up. This is from the Usher Bowl ministry. Yes. Usher Bowl. Yeah, Usher Bowl. Yeah, everybody know about Usher Bowl. They told me to tell y'all that please remember that wear your white Usher gloves when serving on Sundays. If it ain't white, it ain't right. Amen. Amen. They said they've been noticing some of y'all been wearing some different color Usher gloves. That's what they told me to tell y'all. No, that's not right. That's not right. Some of y'all been wearing some red Usher gloves. I don't know if you're trying to match it with your shoes or whatever. I don't know. Oh, they say y'all been wearing some green Usher gloves. And some of y'all been wearing some black Usher gloves. Now, they told me to tell you, those three colors are allowed, but only during Black History Month. That's the only time. Y'all be spicing up a little bit during Black History Month. But if it ain't Black History Month, if it ain't white, it ain't right. Amen? Oh, no, that's what they told me to tell. Hold on. Let me see. I got one more. I got one more. This is really for the ladies. Ladies, ladies, ladies. Now, I know we like to look beautiful on Sundays. We do. But they told me to tell y'all to please refrain from wearing your after six attire to the Sunday morning worship service. Now, that's what they told me to tell you. They said some of y'all coming in there sparkling and glittering and sapphire and just shining all over the place. And it's too early in the morning for that. They say some people not even awake yet. And you come through that door and whoa, I'm right in the door. They're going to wake up. They're going to wake up. But they told me to tell you that because last Sunday, one of the guest ministers was blinded by a sister sequence and diamond and jewel studded. Oh, she was sparkling all over the place. You hear me? And that sunlight came in there and hit that shirt she had on and blinded that man. You hear what I'm talking about? But that man said, thanks be to God, because she gave him his new sermon, which is blinded by God's goodness and grace. Wow, man! Whew, Lord Jesus. Now, I got this. I think it's one more. What is it? Wait a minute. Oh, no, this is not the one. This is one of my pet peeves. I got to go there. I got, church lady got some pet peeve. I lived a long line, long, long time. I'm entitled to some pet peeve. Don't y'all hate when them people sell up a phone and them people be going off in the church? Lord Jesus, they go off all at the wrong time. They go off doing the prayer. They go off and off during the altar call. Now, don't y'all hate it when they go off during the silent reading? They say it's silent on the program. The silent read of the obituaries and funerals. Now, don't y'all hate when that stuff go off like that? Now, y'all know it ain't right. Now, the whole thing is, it would be okay if you could find it.
But half the time y'all can't even find it. And then when you find it, you act like you just bought it and you don't know how to cut it off. Now what in the world is going on? Yes, we are looking at you. Girl, look at that over there. Betty, you see that? She don't know how to turn the phone off. Lord Jesus, help the Lord up all. Turn that phone off and in. So y'all got to realize, you should be able to go to church, and you should be able to start the day. Come on now, people. You got to turn them off sometime. And if you can't turn yours off, because you really did it for it, put it on vibrate. So we don't have to hear it going off. Amen? Because some of y'all got some songs on there that make me want to jump up and do a dance. I ain't telling you the truth. I hear them going off. Hey, poop, 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 poop. Did you hear that from Betty? What in the world she got on that phone? Put that for that ring tone. But I'm telling y'all, turn them on off. The only thing that should be ringing in church is chimes and bells, not y'all beepers and sales. Y'all got to stop opening them peppermints in church on Sunday. See, you know about it. You know about it. Y'all got to stop opening them peppermints in the church. Some of y'all take 15 minutes to get that peppermint out that wrapper. If it's taking too long to get it out like that, that is old. That's been in your purse too long. You need to throw them away, get you a new bag. It shouldn't take that long to get the peppermint out the wrapper. And when we turn around and look at you, no, we don't want one. We want you to cut that noise out. That's what we want. I might miss them calling my name on the sick and shut in list because you opening a peppermint. I might miss my call to discipleship because you opening a peppermint. You need to throw them peppermints away if you've been in your purse. Some of them been in your purse for 10 years. Y'all found out what peppermint and you excited. You gonna eat it. Don't eat that. That's toxic. It's been in there too long. Throw it away. Bring you some candy to church that don't make noise. Bring some gummy bears. Bring some mentos. Bring some chiclets. But stop opening them peppermint wrappers in church. Amen. Woo! Jesus. Jesus had to tell us. Now, I'm going to tell y'all something. Yes, we had to create some new ministries in the church. Yes, we did. He mentioned it over here. That brother know about it over here in this corner. Uh-huh. So we had to create some new ministries out of a need. So we had to create this ministry called the TTBO ministry. Anybody know about that ministry, the TTBO ministry? Y'all don't? I'm going to tell you right now. The TTBO ministry is to take that baby out ministry. Now, see, you know, why y'all looking like that? Why you looking like that? We had to create that ministry. That was a ministry that was created out of a need. Because we realize a lot of parents do not know when they need to take that baby out. So we created a ministry for you. Yes, we did. But I'm going to give you a few signs of when you might need to take your baby out. But if you can't take your baby out, don't even worry about it, because the ministry gonna come and take that baby out. Fuck you, man. That's what we gonna do. But here's a couple of signs. If that baby is running all up and down the aisle in church, just running all over, just running, and it ain't the call of the discipleship moment, you might need to take that baby out. If that baby is jumping up and down on the pew, and you done told that baby to sit down more than 5 times, and that baby ain't paying you no mind, you might need to take that baby out. But if that baby is crying so loud that we can't hear the preacher preaching, you know what I'm talking about, and we turn around and look at you, you need to hurry on up and take that baby out. But I understand what the problem is. You don't want to miss the service, amen. And we want to enjoy the service, amen. So that everybody can get what they want. You don't have to move. Don't you worry about a thing.
Because the people from the TTBO ministry are going to come and take that baby out for you. You sit right there, baby. You got me. But don't you worry about your children, because they will be in the means. Because everybody on this ministry, you know, they love children. They are retired school teachers, retired police officers, detention home workers. We got some doctors, we got some nurses, we got some nutritionists from the, you know, your child will be in good hands. You don't have to worry about your baby. But we are going to start taking those babies out. Amen?
Amen? Amen.
Now, if you want to be a part of this ministry, but you got to really love children to be a part of this ministry, we're looking for you. Amen? Amen. But let me tell you, we got another ministry in the church.
Mm-hmm.
It's the telephone ministry. You know about it, don't you? The telephone ministry. Now, everybody want to be on this ministry because you can be in this ministry and you can do it from home on the telephone. All you need is a telephone. Because what you do is you call members that's been missing for church for maybe 3 months or so, and we haven't seen them. All you do is call them on the phone. Say, hey, girl, where you been? Hey, brother, where you been? Oh, Lord, is anything we can help you with? Anything you need? And then you remind them to still send that tithe in. That's what it's about. It's really about sending that tithe in. So they just want you to call them, remind them whether they ain't coming to church or not, to please send that tithe in. But you know, you can send that tithe in so many ways there. You can do online and do it. You know, you can mail it in. And you can ask a member, you know, that's a member of the church and lend to you, to take it to the church free. Take your envelope in. Now, if you do that third one, I don't mean no harm. I think I will call the church office on that Monday or so, or Tuesday, or later than Tuesday. That might be too long. Might do it Monday to make sure that envelope got there, because you know times is tight. Healthcare is going up. Y'all know what's going on. Y'all know who we got in the office, so it might be a few dollars short. So check on that envelope, amen? But let me tell you, ain't no need to try to join this ministry right now, because this ministry is closed and it has a wait list of over 100 people. Because everybody wants to serve God from home and on the telephone. But you got to come out to the house of the Lord to serve sometime, amen? Amen, amen. Well, I got something else to tell you. Hold up, amen, hold up. Now, this is something y'all still got to stop. Y'all got to stop coming late to church. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Church been starting the same time for 20, 30, 40, 60 years, and y'all still coming in there late. That ain't right, that ain't right. Do you know that's why people in the churches went to three different times for church service? They trying to make you find one that you can be on time for. If you like early morning, you get up early, you can do the 8:00. If you not an early person, then they got the 11:00. Some people even went to 12 noonday service, because they figure all y'all ought to be up by noon or can get up by noon. Y'all got to start being on time for church, amen? Amen. Amen. But I got one more ministry I want to talk to you about, then I'll be out and hold you too long. Now, you know, we had to create another ministry in the church. This was out of a need, too. Yeah, we noticed that. And this ministry is the WTU ministry. Mm-hmm. Y'all know what that means? The Wake Them Up ministry. Jesus, we had to create this one. Because we are no longer going to let you saints fall asleep in church. We're going to wake you up by any means necessary. You are no longer going to sleep in church. Amen? Now, I'm just here to tell you that really I need to be out in the audience to do this one. But you know, I'm trying to do everything from up here. But if I could be out there in the audience, I don't know how my voice carries. But this one, you know, it's a touch hands-on type of ministry. You know what I'm saying? So you got to be, you know, you got to be vigorous. You got to be flexible. You got to be able to move. Because no longer are we going to let you fall to sleep in church. So I think I'm going to come out there anyway, and I'll try to talk as loud as I can, because I got to demonstrate the way it needs to be demonstrated. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Ah! Hallelujah.
Let's give her a hearty amen.
this ministry will be equipped with one of these. Beautiful, isn't it? Beautiful. It's beautiful. And it works good, too. Because no longer are we going to let you fall in secret church. And how much you get depends on how sleep you are. So if you're not too sleepy, you might get a
thank you.
to. One, two. Okay. Yep. One, two. Thank you.
He's even better when the mic is on. Thank you so much, Garrison Family Choir. I enjoy it every time I hear you sing. Almost like I'm singing myself. And thank you, Keith and Kenny, Carlton and Maurice. So that we got to come up with a name for the band. What can we call y'all? Illusions or something? Well, there was one ministry that was not talked about, and that's if people don't act right when you ask them politely, there's another ministry called Choke That Joker. If you were excuse us, we were able to have a friend of ours bring over a Hammond organ. Marsh is playing it. They're going to have to take that back. So we can thank Chris Thomas. But that's going to be packed up as we're still moving along in our program. So if you just excuse our little bit of noise we may make, we appreciate that. The next item we have on the agenda is what? Anybody looking at the program?
The skits.
Okay. Well, one of the little skits that we have. Let's see where the skit went. Oh. You ready, Ken?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay. All right. Okay. One of my talented musicians, of course, is Kenny Cradle. And we'd like to give him a hand. If you can, I don't know if he's going to play with his teeth or his fingers. You could probably do both. If you can guess the song he's playing just by the bass guitar notes.
Yeah.
Yeah, the gospel is next. Because Paul don't have the gospel. You know, we figured we'd change it up a little bit. You know, I mean, we love church and we love gospel, but gospel is made up of R&B. Gospel is made up of blues. Gospel is made up of a whole lot of different music.
All right.
So we just figured we'd just change it up for this one time. Y'all wasn't, I see, by the way y'all was singing, y'all wasn't mad at what I was doing. Y'all wasn't mad at all. Y'all was like hip hop and everything. Everything hip hop and rock and don't stop. Oh, not like that. We're gonna take it to a gospel level now. I'm gonna let my cousin Keith throw you one and see if you know that.
Thank you, Kenny. At this time, we have another little surprise for you. It won't cost you nothing. This one's free. And we have a countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
After I had a good meal, I happened to listen to him. And you know, He gave me some wisdom that I took with me, and then I walked with it, and then I listened to that again, and it was so good that I decided to come back next Sunday. And as I came back next Sunday, they fed me again. I said, boy, this is a good thing. But as they fed me, Jesse fed me with food, Johnny fed me with wisdom. So I had food in one hand and wisdom in the other. And I said, Lord, thank you for what you did. And I started thinking about this thing, and I'm saying, all this dancing and partying I'm doing, I ain't filled. I had an empty heart. But after being there in the church, the choir started singing, the preacher started preaching, and I thought the preacher was talking about me. I started getting offended, because everything he said, I had done. But then I started taking the turkey to personal. But then I realized that everybody else had done the same thing out there. So we are all sinners, I found that out. But you know what? God can take care of all of us. You know, because when you fall down, only a saint can fall down, but God will pick you back up. And that's what I'm coming here to tell you all today. That I'm here by the grace of God. And God picked me up. He told me to take my hat off. He told me to pull my pants down. And shout for joy. And tell me how good God is. You know, because he's going to change. And he's going to change in me. And I'm going to ask Sister Tony Savage, can you just come up here for one minute, please? Just sing a little bit of this change song for me. Just a little bit. Tony Savage, there's only one Tony Savage out here. I know you've been ill and sister, but you know God just said in my heart to please come and just sing just a little bit of change for me, a little change.
Wonderful change has come.
let's say amen for them again. You know, God is bringing many of us through many trials and tribulations. Some of us have lost loved ones. Some of us are dealing with disease, ailments. But through it all, Jesus can take care.
Oh, yes.
Dennis, why don't you come right here?
Yeah.
And They already said that. Okay. Okay, and then we have Aunt Annie and Uncle Bobby sitting there.
The Dean family from New Jersey.
Thank you for next to me, Jordan, just along to the children of the church, Tommy Dean and his family. We want to thank you all. And also, Tommy has a daughter that's here at Hampton University. So we just wanted to let you all know that. You all that live in Hampton, you all reach out, come and go to stand up. You all reach out to her. She needs a home away from home. You know, Otis and Squat Group and all of them, they live right in Hampton. If she needs something, make sure you all take care of her, because that Bobby started off singing that song, we're one in the family, we're one in the Lord. No matter what, we go, we're still one in the family. We just want to thank each and every one of you all. And Tony didn't say something because Tony's so modest. But you know, that organ that just moved out and the drum set, Tony made, he's the one that made way for us to get that today. So let's give him a prayer. Our minister of music, Dr. Carlton Hamilton. And his brother, Marie. I'm just telling you, we don't take anything for granted. They're always there for us in Kenny Cradle. And I don't know about Muppet Calvary. But you know, they're always there all the time. Sometimes it's just like an old shoe. We just take for granted because they're already part of the family. But we, you know, we think about it all the time. But you know what? The family reunion wouldn't be the family reunion without all of them. It's just like you can get the best car in the world, but if you don't have a good battery in it, it's no good. And really, like that song said, it's the wind beneath our wings. And they keep this choir going, they keep us going. Most of all, God keeps all of us going. And we just want to thank each and every one of y'all and hope that y'all have enjoyed yourself. And this is not the last one, this is only 61 years. Because God, he promised us a long life if we want to receive it. And so even though I'm 80 years old, 80 to me is young anymore. When I was like long living Israel, little man, I thought a priest of 50 years old was over the hill. I'm not over the hill. And I want none of y'all over here. Because I just want to say, I just want to thank everyone of y'all. And before I end up, tomorrow the bus is going to be leaving at 12 o'clock. So, and we have a service at 8 a.m. And all you didn't get this afternoon, make sure that you come to the 8 o'clock service. Even though that you're not at your own church, you'll have a home away from home here at the 8 o'clock service tomorrow morning. And I'm sure that God is still going to be in the blessing business. And you, everyone that comes, we will be blessed. And we also have the hospitality room that's going to be open again tonight. And I think they can probably do Easter egg hunt right after this today. And something that I'm going to tell you. Oh, the reunion for next year, Terry, where's Terry Garrison? And Terry and Sally, and that Terry at the head table, Sally and whoever, his entourage. There are going to be many people that's going to be supporting them. They're going to be in charge of the Garrison Family Reunion of the year 2020. And then the year 2021, it's going to probably be someplace in Charlotte, North Carolina. Great Brother King and his entourage. So and the good thing I just need to tell you all because we experienced something yesterday. To me, it's sort of important. And we talked about that. I was telling Dean about it this morning. We all need to listen to this because this is really important. We watched the Mark of the Beast back in 1959 at the Pilgrim Baptist Church. And they were talking about, you know, when the microwave came out and the computer and all of that stuff. And it was said that the time that, and I think it's in the Bible, the time's going to come that you're going to be messed up. And I'm not going to say this is part of the Bible, but it's not real. The only thing that's going to be able to make it with is plastic, because money is not going to be any good. And we had a good lesson on that yesterday, because a lot of people pay down with cash because they're so used to paying their rooms with cash money, but the hotel gives most cash. They want to get a credit card. And they weren't saying so. It was, people were able to help improvisers, and so they end up giving the money to them, and they put that money on their card on to get them in. But for next year, we're going to be in another part of North Carolina. So make sure, if you don't have a credit card now, go and set aside a credit card. So you'll be able to, but your money won't be any good. I don't know, but this is kind of world that we live in, and we can't change it on our own. So let's make sure that everybody that plans to come to the reunion, make sure you always come with a credit card that'll be able to take care of your own. They won't want to be in the whole lot. But we just want to thank you all for coming, and we want to thank this reunion committee with the whole Lee family and the Ford family. But come to find out, I think most of them belong to Robert Lee's church. Yep. We just want to say thank all of you all for being taking care of this reunion this year. I know you all didn't want to do that, especially now. I know Sophie didn't want to do it. But it's only beginning. I know she'd be glad if we got to do it again. We want to say thank you all.
Jesse, I was told to remind everyone there's a stairway outside in the main lobby. They would like to take a couple of group pictures for those that are over 70. They want to have them take a picture on one level, and then everyone else who's not 70 yet, they want to take a picture also on the stairway. So if you will make your way out there, that would be very much appreciated. And either I'm getting married again or somebody lost the ring. I see something shiny in there. Now, I'm not getting married again. But we do have a ring here. If we would stand. Terry, would you please dismiss us in prayer? In a different way. Because there's only one way you can tell us.
Yeah.
And there's only one way you can make it in.
Yeah.
Mom, we need a verse or two.
Thank you.
Father in heaven, we just want to lift up your holy and precious name. Thank you, dear Lord, for your grace and for your mercy. Thank you, dear Lord, for this occasion of the 62nd, the very, very, very 62nd family reunion of the Garrison family. Oh, Lord, we want to thank you for having given traveling grace and mercy to all those who came. We ask you to give them traveling grace and mercy as we depart and return home. We want to thank the host for just making this occasion of reunion just a wonderful and delightful. Thank you, O Lord, for keeping our hearts and our minds focused on thee as we come together to honor the patriarch and matriarch of this family, Reverend Lorenzo Garrison and Alice Garrison, my grandparents, my granddaddy, and Mama Alice. O Lord, we ask you to keep us grounded. Help us, the Lord, continue to look into the hills of which cometh our help. Knowing our help comes from thee, for with thee we can do all things, and without thee we can do nothing. So, Lord, we ask you to continue to teach us that we'll be taught, keep us that we'll be kept, and bless us that we may be blessed. For this is our prayer in the matchless and precious name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen.
Amen.